So, continuing the discussion about the wind power generation, now I will discuss about the power production cost, which decreases tremendously with increasing full yearly load hours. So, electricity generation cost or the power production costs, the specific power generation cost may be determined by annuity calculation that can be derived from the total investments, the annual cost, as well as the expectable energy yields that a certain wind turbine is capable to yield. As usually, a real discount rate of approximately 4.5 and an amortization period that is corresponding to the technical converter service life of 20 year lifetime are assumed, although it might be able to work for, let's say, 30 years or 25 years. Furthermore, constant operation costs are assumed for the entire service life. So, like we made the analysis of three solar systems were basically discussed and their comparative analysis was done. Similarly, three power generation plants that are using the wind power will be considered in this discussion. So this is table 7.3, which shows the power generation costs pertaining to three converter types that was basically defined in our previous slides. That was table 7.2, located at three reference sites. According to the figure, the power generation costs decreases tremendously with increasing yearly full load hour and thus an increasing mean wind velocity. Sites which have the annual wind a mean wind velocity, mean speeds that allow for 4500 hours per annum are very rare and can only be found that in areas which are close to the coastal areas, especially the windy islands or in very exposed locations on shores, the deserts. The power generation costs corresponding to those conditions range from 0.030 to 0.033 kilowatt euros per kilowatt hour. For the conditions analyzed here, compared to the sites with the 2500 hours per annum are more frequently available at good locations close to the coastal areas. Under these conditions, average real specific power generation costs lie between 0.54 and 0.59 euros per kilowatt hour. That is maxima that could have been achieved. If the full load hours are even longer, for example 1800 hours per annum, the electricity provision cost will increase significantly. The comparisons of different converter technologies with different installed capacities do not reveal any significant difference in terms of power generation costs for the same wind speed, respectively, for the same full load hours, independent of the above observation, especially for the specific range from 50 to 1000 kilowatt, which play no significant role in Europe anymore. Specifically, the power generation costs decreases with increasing turbine capacity, and this is mainly due to the tendency towards the reduced investment cost and increasing tower heights for enhanced capacities, which permit to achieve higher wind speeds at hub height at the same site at the mean airflow speed increase with increasing height. As we have also discussed that the wind will face some fluctuation, some resistance at the ground level, and as we go higher from the ground, let's say as at a certain height, H2, the wind speed will be higher at the higher heights when the because of the frictional coefficients that play an important role in overall wind efficiency. The smallest examined converter that converts converter of 1500 kilowatt thus results much more cost effective than the wind energy converters for lower installed capacities. They have thus a lot of importance within the course of the last decade. So now let us move towards their comparative analysis of the three systems, the system 1, 2 and 3 that have been discussed in table 7.3. The location of system 1 at site 3 will affect a 59.76% decrease in power generation cost as compared to the site 1. Similarly, the location of system 2 at site 3 affects approximately 60% decrease in power generation cost as compared to the site 1. And similarly, the location of system 3 at site 3 will affect 60% decrease in power generation cost as compared to the site 1. So we can conclude that the highest decrease in power generation cost when moving to sites with improved full load hours will occur for the system number 2, that is 60.26. Deployment of the system number 3 in favor of system number 1 at site 1 will results in 8.54% decrease in power generation cost. Similarly, the deployment of system number 3 in favor of system 1 at site 2 will result in 8.47% decrease in power generation cost. And similarly, the deployment of system 3 in favor of system 1 at site 3 will result in 9.09% decrease in power generation cost. So it can be concluded that the highest saving in power generation cost is obtained when 2000 kilowatt system is used instead of 2 kilowatt system at site number 3. Now this is the basic diagram that will discuss about the sensitivity analysis. The power generation costs are influenced by the multiple parameters that include these interest rates, the depreciation period, the overall investment, the yearly costs and the full load hours that basically determine the electricity generation cost. To estimate the impact of these parameters, this figure shows the variation of the main influencing variables and related effect on resulting power generation cost. For this purpose, a site with 2500 hours of wind per annum and a 2.5 megawatt converter is analyzed. So it shows that the full load hours and thus the site specific annual wind speed have the biggest impact on power due to the generation costs due to the increase in mean wind speed at increased height above the ground, and there is a tendency towards ever higher tower to allow for optimum exploitation of the available wind quantities that are available for a specific site. Besides the annual full load hours, the investment costs represents the second deciding factor with regard to the specific power generation cost. The operation costs, the interest rates, and the amortization period by contrast only have a slight impact on the power generation of the wind systems.